It was October. I've got it pulled up here. October of 2020, and it was a Spanish. It was Marta Castillo who published. She was the lead author on this one out of Spain. There was a little issues with the randomization, so probably the effect was overemphasized. But if you look at the effects, they were quite dramatic. There, in the calcifediol group, let's just back up a little bit. What's calcifediol? That's the name that we give to 25-hydroxy vitamin D. So in this study, they didn't give just vitamin D. They gave the product of the metabolism in the liver of vitamin D.
Now, do you think that's important for someone that is undergoing, let's say, I mean, if you're so sick and maybe your liver's not working properly, your kidneys aren't working, I mean, how are you going to convert these vitamin D metabolites into this steroid hormone, right? So do you think it's important to give someone that more, you know, more downstream, like an active form versus vitamin D3, for example?
Exactly. And so that's the question, is whether, because it takes some time for the vitamin D to be metabolized in the liver. I've seen some people say up to, you know, 7 days. It probably is a little bit less than that. But when you have, when you're giving vitamin D in the acute situation, it doesn't really matter if you're just supplementing over a long period of time and you're hoping to prevent yourself from having a bad outcome with COVID-19. But if you've already got COVID-19, what they may be saying here is that supplementing not with vitamin D, the product prior to liver metabolism, but in fact calcifediol, 25-hydroxy vitamin D, might be a more efficacious intervention. And that's what they did in this study.